friends, welcome back. So let us discuss about the physical address of 8086 microprocessor, how you will calculate the physical address. So before going to know about the calculation of physical address, you have to know about the concept memory segmentation. So memory segmentation. So what is a memory segmentation? So actually the total memory size is divided into segments of various size. First is a total memory, whatever the capacity of that processor, that is a total memory capacity. Total memory size is divided into segments of various sizes. So not only the equal, it may be various sizes. So whereas segments is nothing but it's just an area in a memory, just you call it as an area in memory. Okay, so this you call the process of dividing memory, you call it as a segmentation. So this complete process of dividing memory into segments, we call it as a segmentation. So in memory, data is stored as bytes. So let's first write this point. In memory, data is stored as bytes. So each byte is having 8 bits. So data is stored as bytes. So each byte has some specific address. So suppose this is a memory. So divided into segments. So each byte, so this is 1 byte and this is byte. Each byte is specified with some address. So some 2000, 2002, 2004, like that. Each byte is specified, is having some specific address. And next, whatever the Intel 8086 microprocessor has 20 lines address bus. So here the address bus is having 20 lines instead of 16 lines. So in 8085 it is having 16 lines, but 8086 is having, the data bus is having 16 lines, whereas address bus is having 20 lines. So whatever the data that is holding this segment, so suppose one is a code segment, stack segment, data segment, extra segment, like that. So each segment can store only travel 16 bit of data, whereas address bus is 20. So we have to convert that into 20. The data has to be converted to 20. Okay. So Intel 8086 has 20 lines address bus. So with 20 address lines, the memory can be addressed as 2 power 20 bytes. So the total memory that can be addressed as 2 power 20 bytes, that is equal to 1 megabyte. So the total memory capacity of 8086 is 1 megabyte, that is 2 power 20 bytes. 20 is the address lines. So 2 power 20 bytes is equal to 1 megabyte. So thus 8086 can access memory with address ranging. So the address ranging is from 00000. Here you are writing 5 bits instead of 4 bits because it is a 20 lines address bus. So H2FFFFFH, hexadecimal value. Okay, so this is about the how the memory is allocated in 8086 microprocessor. Now 8086 microprocessor has 4 different types of segments. So I already explained this about in the internal architecture. So what are the 4 different types of segments that are present? Code segment, next data segment, stack segment, and extra segment. So these are the 4 segment registers that are used in the 8086 microprocessor. So here each segment register has size 16 bit. Each occupies 16 bit. So each register stores the base address, that is the starting address of the corresponding segment. Because the segment register cannot store 20 bits, then only store the only store the upper 16 bit. So what I am saying here is the code segment. So whatever the each register stores the base address. First, it stores the base address. Base address is nothing but the starting address of the memory. That segment starting address, I am saying that segment, suppose the code segment is there, the code segment starting address, you call it as a base address. So each register stores the base address of the corresponding segment, because the segment register cannot store 20 bits. They can only store upper 16 bits only. They cannot store 20 bits. That's why we are adding the base address also. So let me explain with the example. One question I will raise here. How is 20 bit address obtained if there are only 16 bit registers? So whatever the registers we are using here, the code segment, data segment, stack segment, extra segment, in that the data is storing. But here we are using 16 bit register. Then how is 20 bit address obtained if we are using only 16 bit register? So that's why we have to convert that 16 bit registers data into 20 bit. Okay, to travel the data on this 20 bit address bus. So let me explain with example how I am going to be converted. Let us take the data segment value is 2222H. So this is 16 bit data, 16 bit value. So this is the 16 bit I want to convert into 20 bit. So to convert this 16 bit address into 20 bit, the bus interface unit appends, means adds 0H to least significant bit of address. So the bus interface unit appends zero value to LSB, the least significant bit. Now the starting address, the base address of the starting address means the base address of data segment is becomes 22220H. So this is how you are converting. So here you have seen only 16 bit of data. So 16 bit of data contains only 16 bit of address. But I converted this data to the 16 bit address, that is the base address, the starting address of this data segment is 22220H. Okay, so this is a 20 bit data or address, 20 bit address. So just you have to add 0 in the LSB of the data, then it becomes a 20 bit address. So this is how you are just simply converting. So if the data at any location has a logical address specified, so whatever the location you have taken, that is a logical address is specified. So that is that logical address can be expressed in, logical address is specified like 2222H, this is a data segment value, and 0016H. So this you call it as a offset value, that is a displacement. And this you call it as the value of data segment. So this is a calculation of the logical address. Okay, so whatever you are doing to calculate the effective address of a memory, the bus interface unit uses this formula to calculate effective address of memory. So if you want to calculate the effective address of a memory, the bus interface unit uses the formula as effective address is equal to starting address, that is the base address, starting address of a segment, that is the base address of a segment, plus offset. So this is the formula you have to be noted for calculating the effective address of the memory. So effective address of the memory means you have to convert the 16-bit of address to the 20-bit address. So with the help of this formula, you have to add the starting address of the segment and plus offset, you will get the effective address of that memory. Okay. So in the next video, I'll explain with an example how the value will be calculated by using different segments. Thank you.